Welcome to the Hip Hop Gamer Show. One love and God bless.
He's sleeping. Now I can play all night.
Gamer Show. Yo, what's up, baby? It's Sunday. You already know. Ain't nothing else to do. How you guys feeling out there? You know what I'm saying? One love and God bless. I got a banging show for you guys today as usual. So let's get it in, man. First things first, though. We're going to start out with this. I'm going to give a big shout out to the whole God of War 3 development team. The whole God of War 3 development team. Big shout out to you guys, man. But also, I want to give a special shout out to my man Stig and a special shout out to my man Sisu Kim. You guys, if you want to, you know, try to contact with them or have a conversation with Stig and Cecil, they actually signed up to the hiphopgamershow.com. So you know, make sure you come out, sign up to hiphopgamershow.com, get a chance to speak to Stig and, you know, other God of War 3 development team. And I'm working on getting more development studios to jump on in. Shout out to Chris Trimble too, because he's there. He's one of the guys behind Transformers. So yeah, get involved, get on the site, sign up. It's crazy. Also, I want to give a big shout out to my man Andrew from NVIDIA. This dude is off the hook. I love this dude. So shout out to him. Shout out to my boy Big Lex, because I got a surprise for you guys. Hip Hop Gamer featuring Luciano the Joker, brand new song, Death of the Industry, for the Hip Hop Arts S today. So stay tuned to all of that. Everything is great. You know what I mean? Now, let's get it in with the game news. First off, I want to tell you guys that Splinter Cell, like I told you before, it is coming to PS3. As of right now, from what I know, it's coming to the PS3. But the announcement of this of the Splinter Cell may come later this year. But like I said, to my knowledge, it's not Conviction. So Conviction will be exclusive, but the next games in the franchise is supposed to be multi-platform and stuff like that. So stay tuned to that. But what I want to ask you guys is, Splinter Cell on PS3, you know, after seeing all these games on PS3, you see what I'm saying, in terms of the exclusive titles and the major jumps that PS3 is, you know, showing as a console, do you think the Splinter Cell game will be hurt, or will they really take advantage of what the PS3 has to offer? Because a game like Splinter Cell, as big as it is and open and dynamic, there's so many things, like, you know, you could do, like, utilizing the power of the PS3. But if you just make a port, it's obviously going to be, you know, roughly exactly the same. You know what I mean? So that right there, you know, is very interesting. So I wanted to get you guys' take on that. How do you think the Splinter Cell on PS3 will turn out? And if it don't turn out, I guess, up to par, you know, what would you say about, you know, Ubisoft's development team on the PS3? Because if you look back at Bayonetta, and people were saying that the PS3 version wasn't as good as the 360 version, it's kind of hard to, you know, accept that, considering you was just coming off a major Uncharted 2 title, which really revolutionized gaming. You know what I'm saying? So when you look at things like that, Splinter Cell port on the PS3, how do you guys believe, like, what do you feel is going to happen when it's announced? Will it just be a port? Or do you feel that the devs will take time out to take advantage of it, of the system, simply from what PS3 has been showing and what the devs have been showing on an exclusive standpoint, like exclusive scale? You feel me? So I just wanted to put that out there, because that right there is going to be huge. You know, when it comes down to it, that's going to be huge. Now, the next thing I want to talk about is this. Ghost Recon. Now, at the moment, this is supposed to be an exclusive feature to the 360, but Ubisoft got their hands on Natal. Ubisoft got their hands on Natal, yo, and Ghost Recon is supposed to have Natal support. But if everything is executed properly, to my understanding, it's over. It is over. I'm telling you. Like, alright, check this out. In Ghost Recon, you know, you got your squad, and you push up, down, left, right on your directional pad to give out certain commands and everything, right? Imagine taking that option away, and the commands that's programmed in the game for you to say, you say them, and Natal recognizes it. That is insane, stupid, retarded, oh my God, yo. That's crazy. Now, think about it. You playing the game, you in the heat of a battle. Instead of taking time out to push all these buttons to do this and do that, even though it may be quick and intuitive, imagine just being like this. Breach. Open and breach. You know what I mean? Or be like this. Around the corner to the side. Flashbang. Flashbang. Imagine doing that. And do it. Like that right there is crazy. And that will make the game that much more personal. You'll have that much more control over it. You see what I'm saying? That right there is forward movement in gameplay. That's next generation right there. You know what I mean? And that one thing right there may very well be exclusive to the 360 version of Ghost Recon. And I'll tell you right now, if that's the case, like, Sony, they will have to use the PlayStation 9 camera for voice or something. They have to do something. Because if not, I mean, the Ghost Recon is going to sell on 360 the most. Forget install base. Just having that feature in there. You're going to have to get that. You got to get that version. You got to get in the tall. You got to get in the tall. Like, for that, that right there is amazing. So, Ghost Recon, the tall support, you know, your own voice commands. That right there is going to change the game. So, stay tuned for that, because that particular announcement may come around the E3 area. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, stay tuned for that. Now, another thing that I feel is really, really good. This is really, really crazy. Now, if you think about this, right? I'm gonna put you on something. 3D gaming, everybody's going crazy. 3D gaming is like the future, right? I already had my little taste of 3D gaming with Bad Company.